The problem is N-Queen's problem. First, let us understand what does it mean by N-Queen's problem, then I'll explain you how backtracking is used for solving this problem. See here, a chessboard is given of 4x4, 16 cells. A standard chessboard will be of 8x8, but for reducing the size of a problem, we have taken 4x4. And 4 queens are given. So in a game of chess, a queen will be there, which will have its moves like horizontal, that is in a row or in a column or diagonal it moves. So here also it's the same queen. And that queen, we have to place them on this board. So all 4 queens we have to place such that no 2 queens are under attack. So when do you say they are under attack? If they are in same row or same column or they are in same diagonal. So if they are in same row, same column or same diagonal. So we have to avoid this and arrange them such that they are not under attack. So is it possible to arrange them? Yes, it is possible. We get some solutions. Is there only one solution? No. For this, we will have more than one solution and we want all those solutions. So now, we want to know what all their possible arrangements. From there, we want those arrangements which are satisfying this condition. So for this type of problem, backtracking is used. We want all possible solutions which are satisfying this condition, not just one solution. If we are looking for optimal, then we should go for dynamic programming. We want all solutions which are satisfying this condition. So backtracking is used. Now let us discuss how to solve this one. Those 4 queens, I'll place them on this 4x4 chessboard. So in how many ways I can place them on this 16 cells? So I can place them in 16c4 ways. So this will form a lot of possibilities and the problem becomes big. No, to reduce the size, what we will say that a queen cannot be kept anywhere on the board, but first queen in first row, second queen in second row, likewise. So it means now what we have to decide, we don't have to decide the cell. We have to decide in which column a queue will be placed. So those columns will write here. First queen, which column it will be, then second queen, third queen and fourth queen. So we'll write on their column numbers. So now the problem is reduced. And one more thing we'll do. We will try to avoid keeping 2 queens in the same column. Okay. Actually, we have to check this condition. So one condition we already solved. What? We will not keep all the queens in a single row, every queen in the next row. So first row is problem solved. Then we know we are placing them. We have to solve it. So for that, we will try to avoid keeping 2 queens in the same column. So these two are directly we are taking care. Now we have to check are the queens in the same diagonal or not. Right? So now by checking all these conditions, what we will do is, we will try to solve it and prepare the solutions in the form of a solution tree, that is state space tree. So I will generate state space tree now. Let us generate a state space tree. This is the root. Now first queen, I will keep it in first column. Queen 1 in first column. Then queen 2, as we decided, will not keep it in the same row and same column, but in diagonal. No, actually, it should not be in diagonal. They should not be under attack. No, I'm not checking that attack. Without attack only, just I am drawing what are the possibilities. Okay. Then afterwards, I'll show you how to check the attacks and how to generate a tree. First, without attacks, I am preparing a state space tree. Second queen in second column. Then third queen can come in third column. Yes, third queen can come in third column. So fourth queen in fourth column. This is one possibility. Now, this is one possibility, right? Though they are under attack, right? But beyond this, is there any possibility of moving fourth queen? No. So move back. For third queen, there is a place. So move third queen to a fourth column. Then this will be filled with fourth queen. So third queen goes into fourth column and fourth queen comes in third column. This is how we represent the possibilities. That's what I am showing you. Now continue. Can I keep fourth queen anywhere? No. Third queen, there is no place. So take out. See, this is the last cell. Now move second queen. Second queen in third column. So second queen in third column. Then third queen in second column. Third queen in second column. Then fourth queen in fourth column. Fourth queen in fourth column. Now fourth queen, there is no place. Take out. Third queen, can I keep it here? We decided we will not keep in the same column, so keep it here. So third queen will go into fourth column. Then fourth queen can come in second column. Then here. Now is there any place for fourth queen? No place. Third queen, no place. Second queen, you can move it to fourth column. Second queen can be moved to fourth column. Then third queen in second and fourth in third. Then this is third, this is second. Then go back. Now for second queen also there are no places available. Then take out this, move queen one. Queen one in second column. Now below this also you get a huge tree like this. Then again third column you get a tree, you get a tree like this. So total how many cells we will be checking like this for this one. See, this is first node. Let us check the nodes. So here I will get four nodes. This is in third column as well as fourth column. So four nodes. Then below each node here, three nodes are there. So four into three nodes plus. Then below this two nodes are there. Below this every node. So four into three into two nodes plus. Last one nodes are there. So four into three into two into one. These many nodes will be generating when we have avoided same row and same column, but we are allowing diagonals. So then how much this is? This is 1 plus summation of, now this I takes values from 1, 2, 3, 4 terms are there. So I takes values 0 to 3. So I am starting from 0 to 3. Then this is product of what? 4 minus j, and j takes the values. This is 0 to I. This is I, right? This will be a formula for knowing the number of nodes. If I simply calculate, this is 1 plus 4 and this is 12 plus 24 plus 24. So this is 48, 60 and 65. 65 nodes we'll be getting. This is for 4 queens. If you take 8 by 8, it will be 8 minus j. For any n queens, this will be the number of nodes that will be getting, generating for solving this one. So this is showing the maximum number of nodes. So formula is for maximum number of nodes. We will not be generating all of them, but maximum this may be generated. Now we will solve the problem by following this method only, right? And what is the condition for us? Bonding function is that they should not be in the same row and same column and same diagonal. So I will consider that and I will generate a tree. And now we will be solving the problem. So I will redraw the tree again by applying bounding function. That is the condition. Now let us solve this with bounding function. So what is bounding function? Bounding function is condition, right? So what is the condition? Not in same row, same column and same diagonal, right? We will check this one. Now I will draw the same tree once again. First step is queen 1 in first column. Queen 1 in first column. Then queen 2 in second column. Queen 2 in second column. They are under attack. So don't go further. Kill this node by applying this condition, bounding function. This has violated the condition, so we have killed this node. So we cannot keep it there. Then pick up queen 2 from there and keep it in third column. Queen 2 in third column. So the next possibility is a queen 2 in third column. Is it under attack? No. Continue further. Queen 3 in second column. We will not keep it in the same column, right? Second column. Second column, it will be under attack. So queen 3 in second column, bounding function, this will be under attack. Don't keep it there. Now let us try another cell. This we will not keep it in same column, so we'll keep it here. Queen 3, this column. Queen 3 in fourth column. So queen 3 in fourth column. There also it is under attack. So no question of placing fourth queen at all, right? Third queen itself did not find its place. Is there any other cell remaining for third queen? No. Now we have to move second queen. So okay, move second queen. So second queen is moved in fourth column. So this is in fourth column. Now third queen, second column, third queen in second column. Yes, this is possible for third queen. They are not under attack. Now fourth queen, what is the cell remaining here? Fourth queen, if I keep here, it will be under attack in third column. So if it is in third column, fourth queen, right, this will be under attack, so killed. So pick up fourth queen. Can I keep it here? No. All cells are over. Now queen 3, it can be kept here. So that is in third column. Third column. But that is diagonally under attack. So don't go further. This is killed. So can I keep it at this place? No, we are not keeping in the same column. Now move queen 2. Queen 2 cannot be moved. So pick up queen 2 also and move queen 1. So queen 1 in second column. So queen 1 in second column. Now queen 2, it can be kept here. Queen 2 at first column. This is under attack diagonally. Second column will not keep it, third column. Third column. Again under attack diagonally. Now let us keep it in fourth column. Fourth column. Yes, this is possible. They are not under attack. Now let us keep third queen. So we found a place for second queen, then only try to keep third queen. Third queen, can I keep it in column 1? Yes, third queen in column 1. So x3 in column 1. So third queen is here. They are not under attack. Now fourth queen, this cell will not keep here only. This is the only place. So queen 4 in third column. Is it under attack? No, we got a solution. What is that solution? 2, 4, 1, 3. 2, 4, 1, 3. Actually, these values, we were trying them here in an array. Now I have written the answer finally. So 2, 4, 1, 3. This is one answer, right? And I have to continue further and I try to find out any more answers are possible. So yes, there is one more answer if you continue doing this. What is the other answer? See, mirror image of this one. So Q1 will be on this side and Q2 on this side and Q3 this side, Q4 here. Mirror image of this one. So that is 3, 1, 4, 2. So 3, 1, 4, 2. So what are the answers? Solutions are, there are two solutions. One is 2, 4, 1, 3 and 3, 1, 4, 2. That's it. So I have shown you, before this one, I have shown you all possibilities. Now I have used bounding function and solved this using backtracking.